You know, temperature, of course, because sometimes it is too high. Droughts, but not so many so far. The most important factor for us is still heavy rain.
We don't have those a lot of risks about the flooding or about other factors, but of course the air pollution is the thing that we need to measure and we need to take it down, and the use of cars, we need to prepare bicycle roads so the people can use the bicycles and other sustainable transport.
Just a week ago, we had a very heavy rains in Klaipėda, and the central part of the city was flooded. So that means that we not invest enough money for infrastructure.
A rapid change of weather, a lot of storms, and a lot of hot days.
The most risk factor is capacity, resources, human resources, and money.
I think that it would be good to have common guidelines, then try on the basis of these general guidelines, prepare some strategies and local plans related to what you have in your municipality, and involvement of all who can work on this topic. And also, I think, international cooperation, cross-sectoral cooperation, that is what we really need.
Of course, we need more programs so we can have projects in. We need more cooperation, we need more action to show the benefits of sustainable development, to care about our planet and our Europe, our city, our country. So I believe that more projects, more funding and more cooperation between the cities of the Union, of the Baltic cities or European Union.
I would say, I would agree, there was some presentation, somebody told that education. I would say I totally agree that education of residents is main thing, and another thing is investments.
Common projects, especially how we can use nature-based solutions instead of green infrastructure instead of gray infrastructure. And this is how we can change experience and work together. And because climate is similar, attitude is similar. We are living in one Baltic space, and I think what is good in Finland or in Sweden, it could be the same in Baltic states as well.
It's important to have an exchange of best practices. And that's why I think the UBC and the Sustainable Cities Commission is a very good way to share experiences and best practices.